The Raceline NASCAR News Brief, your weekly quick look into NASCAR, broadcast worldwide through YouTube on the Auto Channel.
Welcome back to Raceline This Week. I'm Tiffany Ricardo with a look at this week's news.
The big news story this week, probably the biggest of the year, is the announcement that Dale Earnhardt Jr. is leaving his family-owned business, Dale Earnhardt Incorporated. Jr. had been negotiating with DEI for the last several months and had demanded a majority ownership as part of a renewal plan. Apparently, his stepmother, Teresa Earnhardt, did not agree to those terms, and now Jr. says he's going out on his own.
At 32 years of age, the same age as my father was when he made his final and most important career decision, it is the time for me to compete on a consistent basis and contend for championships now.
Junior's possibilities, of course, include Richard Childress Racing, which would be a delight to fans if Junior drove the number 3 Chevy that his late dad drove. But for now, that's just speculation. Teresa Earnhardt, CEO of DEI, stated that the team is disappointed that Junior is leaving, but that DEI would continue to thrive and win.
We've talked to a couple of drivers recently on Raceline about the plan to switch to ethanol possibly in the future in the Nextel Cup Series. Well, now it looks like Chevrolet is making a formal petition to NASCAR to do just that, switch over to ethanol. With more, here's Raceline producer Mike Brialt.
Well, Tiffany, everybody agrees that the switch to ethanol would not only be good for NASCAR, but it would also be good in helping everybody ease off of our dependence on foreign oil. But it's not as easy as it sounds. Ethanol produces less power per gallon, so cars would either need a larger fuel cell or require 3 times as many pit stops. And both are safety considerations. Also, several stainless steel components in the engine would need to be changed. Since ethanol is organic, it would be more corrosive to those parts. Another hurdle might be that one of NASCAR's 4 vehicle manufacturers, Toyota, isn't in the marketplace yet with an ethanol vehicle. Toyota's alternative fuel success has come largely in the electric hybrids. Well, NASCAR just completed the switch over to unleaded fuel, and that's only a couple decades behind the rest of the world. Maybe the switch to ethanol will happen a lot quicker, Tiffany.
Thanks, Mike, and it was really good to hear some news from Jerry Nadeau, the former Nextel Cup driver, who was very seriously injured at Richmond in a practice crash 4 years ago. Nadeau looks like he's making a comeback. He ran an enduro karting race in Portugal, or actually he will run it, coming up on June the 1st. And Nadeau's maybe going to try to get back into NASCAR. We hope to see him back someday really soon, because he's been very much missed in the Nextel Cup Series. Well, crew chief Matt Borland is once again job shopping after being released by Michael Waltrip Racing before the Richmond event. The UPS crew chief, the former UPS crew chief, I should say, did lose his job before Richmond, and the team then failed to make that event. Dale Jarrett had used his final champions provisional the week before at Talladega. Jason Burdett stepped up to the crew chief spot on the UPS team. However, didn't seem to make much difference there as that team did go home. Latest rumors have Ray Evernham interested in Matt Borland, possibly filling a crew chief job at his team. Well, that's a look at this week's news. I'm Tiffany Ricardo. More Raceline coming up right after this.
Thanks for watching. Be sure to catch the full Raceline show each week on your local TV station and worldwide on the AutoChannel.com.